best part about being in showbiz. Craft services. It's like never-ending supply of free food all day long. I never had to pay for a single meal. Hey, Patrick, I noticed you guys don't do that here in your studio. You should talk to your boss. Maybe even just a bagel station. Science community also complained about these Terra whatever's breathing fire. Like there's fossil evidence of dinosaurs not ever shooting fireballs. It's not like I gave them neck frills or had them spit poison or anything ridiculous like that. Luck would have it, the next lot to ours was filming some horror movie set in Transylvania. So we signed a soft contract with them to use their set after they wrapped for the day. And by that I mean we kind of snuck in and filmed it real quick when no one was looking. Had my assistant Phyllis keep a lookout for the security guard. those days, the effects team really nailed it. Dinosaurs, saucers, hey, you name it. But these deflating rock boulder cubes, not their best work. Just looks kind of odd, if you ask me, like giant whoopee cushions. And they said they could add some debris and explosions or two afterwards. And then we ran out of budget. Well, to be fair, we ran out of budget several times, but still, I lost a lot of sleep over these rocks.
Backstory on Dick? Why'd he travel to Gregoria in the first place? Did he do any research before landing there? Did he have a specific mission in that region of space?
Patrick, Patrick, if you keep getting bogged down by the details, how will you ever learn to just sit back and appreciate the work of art for what it is? Production tip, ladies and gentlemen, no matter how sunny it is, don't store your papier-mâché props outdoors. They will get rained on. It's the law in this town, like Occam's razor or Stockholm syndrome or I forget what it's called.
What in the cosmos? It's my co-pilot's body. I believe that I can repair it. Oh no! I am trapped!
Master Dick. Master Dick. Options restored. Threat detected. Must eliminate.
Fun fact. And we actually had an actor inside the robot suit moving him around. I bet you thought it was an actual robot, huh? That's how good he was. No rest breaks or anything. Hardest working actor I've ever met. What a trooper. It was a shame we couldn't afford to pay him. And of course, since he wasn't on the payroll, I couldn't officially add him to the credits. But still, what a trooper. Wish I had a dozen actors like him.
Dangerous radiation detected. With extreme prejudice. Alien slimes terminated.
Same material for the toxic waste as we did the slimes. I mean, why fake something when you have the real deal available? We found a place where people were just dumping the stuff away for free. I was hoping the crew members handling it might get some cool superpowers from it, but no, nothing like that.
down upon me with great vengeance and furious anger.
Oh, Robot, you're all right! And you saved the day.
Threat eliminated.
Looks like the Emperor's days are numbered. At long last, we have assembled our team.
A lot of reviewers and fans, too, always wondered why we shot so few scenes with all three heroes in it together. I mean, we did our best to explain it, something about the sleep chambers or staying back to protect the ape village. Really, it was just logistics. Jonathan had bowling league on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and Stacy had her karate Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Honestly, we almost never had all of them on the set at the same time. Our robot actor was in some religion that only allowed him to work.